Spiders are amongst the world's most fascinating and extraordinary animals. Spiders evolved about 400 million years ago. We now have tens of thousands of species of spiders across the world. But they all share some common characteristics. All spiders are hunters. They will attack and consume large numbers of bugs, of insects, and they're very important in controlling the numbers of invertebrates. Spiders hunt in a number of different ways. Some are sit and wait predators. Others make a web and trap their prey. Yet others will throw lines of silk onto prey as they move past. Spiders have an extraordinary physiology. Their lungs are located in their abdomens. Spiders will have multiple eyes, and they have lenses like we do, and have extraordinary vision. They have a brain about 30% of the size of their body, and they need a huge brain simply to control their legs as they move around the place.
Hello, my name's Mike. I run the Discovery Centre at the South Australian Museum. That's an area where people bring things into the museum, and we regularly get spiders of all sorts. People find spiders in their garden, in the bush, in their shed, wherever. But people are fascinated by spiders. Even if they don't like them, they tend to be fascinated by them and want to know what they are and whether they're poisonous.
Having citizens assist scientists means that we can collect data over large geographic areas. For instance, Operation Spiders collecting information from around South Australia. The Globe at Night project is collecting data worldwide. Or we can collect data from places that are typically difficult to access, like people's back gardens, that are important habitat for the wildlife species that we've been studying.
Some of the main spiders that get brought into the museum are trapdoor spiders. People find them in the garden and instantly recognise them as being a dangerous spider, which they're not. They live in a hole in the ground. They feed on crickets and cockroaches and various other pests that we have in the garden. Another one that we get in the Adelaide Hills is called a mouse spider. It lives for 3 years. At that point, it reaches maturity, and then it goes wandering around looking for a mate. We also get quite a number of wolf spiders. They're probably the most common spider that we get around. There are a number of different species of wolf spiders, ranging in size from around about the size of a pinhead right up to a leg span that might be anything up to 100 millimetres. You won't see them in the daytime unless you actually dig them up in the garden.
So there are thousands of species of spiders across the country, across the globe. And you will have many different sorts in your house and in your garden. Some you may not even know are there. So go outside, go look for them and see what wonderful spiders and see what they're doing in your backyard.
Importantly, citizen science projects increase knowledge and experience in the community. And these are two things that can help change attitudes and behaviours of the 6.5 billion plus people on the planet. So while they are engaged and learning about the environment and about science, they're also helping scientists to collect data or to analyse data and to understand how the environment is changing. So get involved in citizen science projects for yourself, for the community, and for science. It makes a difference.